As of March 31st of 2025, there are currently 47 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is one less than were erupting last week. One of these, which is the only volcanic complex to be actively erupting in Alaska, is its remote Great Sitkin Volcano. Located in the Aleutian Islands 26 miles east-northeast of the nearest populated settlement, the Great Sitkin Volcano is currently undergoing its single longest eruption on record, which has been ongoing for 1,405 days or 3.85 years. In this time span, a very large basaltic andesite lava dome has not only filled the western two-thirds of its summit caldera, but also spilled over and flowed downslope by as much as 3,600 feet. This eruption could continue for multiple more years. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Japan, new volcanic unrest, including a swarm of earthquakes and tilt meter changes, have been detected, causing the Kirishima Volcano's alert level to be raised. Meanwhile, in the Azores island chain, a shallow submarine volcano seemingly produced an unusually strong earthquake swarm involving dozens of magnitude 2 or larger earthquakes, a few of which could be felt on adjacent islands. And, in what is this week's top story, there was a significant change at one of the planet's most historically deadly volcanoes, Mount Awu, suggesting an increased risk of the new unrest progressing towards an eruption later in the year. For reference, Mount Awu is a largely basaltic andesite stratovolcano that comprises the northern section of Sangihe Island. This volcano is noteworthy for its fairly frequent, at least in historical times, Paleian explosive eruptions that have generated long-traveling and deadly pyroclastic flows and lahars. For example, its 1966 eruption was more than twice the size as the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens. Since May of 2023, Mount Awu has been undergoing a slow escalation in unrest, likely due to a new batch of magma filling and then rising from its magma chamber. At one point during a peak in activity in August of 2024, magma was likely only a few hundred meters below the summit of the volcano. And yet, this magma seemingly stalled and solidified without triggering an eruption. After activity continually declined for a time, this trend suddenly reversed during the last week. There has been new uplift detected, a large crack has suddenly appeared on its 2004 lava dome, and carbon monoxide emissions have increased. However, what is most important is that Awu produced its highest level of low-frequency earthquakes during its entire multi-years-long unrest. For reference, quoting word-for-word from the U.S. Geological Survey, long-period or low-frequency earthquakes are caused by cracks resonating as magma and gases move towards the surface. In my opinion, a new batch of magma is attempting to break through a portion of the mostly solidified failed 2024 intrusion, which is causing these earthquakes. How far this fresh magma might have progressed is uncertain, but it is a good time to remind everyone to stay out of this volcano's 3-kilometer exclusion zone in all directions around its summit. While most magmatic intrusions fail to reach the surface and produce an eruption, only time will tell what happens next. Heading over to Japan, since March 28th, changes have been occurring at the Kirishima volcano, suggesting a chance that it may soon erupt. The rate of volcanic earthquakes beneath its most active crater, Shinmodaki, has been continually increasing this week, occurring alongside a tilt meter change indicating the movement of fluids at depth. Then, on March 30th, a 10-minute-long volcanic tremor was detected, suggesting potential magma movement in the vent's magma conduit. Occurring alongside this, the crater has begun degassing at an elevated level. As a result, the alert level of Kirishima's Shinmodaki vent was raised from yellow to orange, and people were told to be cautious of potential volcanic hazards within a 4-kilometer radius of its summit. Meanwhile, in the Azores, an unusual and strong earthquake swarm struck between the islands of São Miguel and Terceira. This occurred at a little-known active submarine volcano called Dom João de Castro Bank, which last erupted in 1720, forming a temporary island. Since then, multiple unusual earthquake swarms thought to be due to magma movement have occurred, strangely enough, all creating a chain of earthquakes that run perpendicular to the lineament this volcanic complex exists on. Well, another such earthquake swarm began on March 25th, and since then more than 40 magnitude 2 or larger earthquakes have struck, the largest of which was a magnitude 4.3. While this activity could technically signal that a submarine eruption of low intensity is actively underway, I have found no evidence that this is the case. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on March 31st of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, LAB, for supporting this channel.